Hello, everyone. Welcome to NekoCast. And I hope you are all fresh and ready in this glorious morning. This is the first edition of my podcast, and I really hope you are going to like it. I've been gathering a little bit of equipment that I had at home, and I'm going to be trying this. So welcome to NekoStudio number 2, because number 1, well, it's at home, but I'm not at home right now. So technically, this podcast is going to be about, like, anything, you know, like, everything we love, you know, like, video games, sometime movies, manga, anime, you know, everything that we really, really like. I am just going to adjust the camera here. Where is it? I cannot adjust. So, I guess we'll go with that. So, we will start this morning with, we're going to start this morning with, like, news that, I don't know if, like, lots of people are going to appreciate or something, but it is something that's been in the talk for quite some time, and it's been revealed. It's going to be the great return of Night Trap. After 25 years, this good old controversial game from 1992 that came in on Sega CD with 3 different US releases. I don't remember why, but anyway, that was it. And we're going to watch a little bit of it, see what it is for those who don't really remember. But just know that soon you will be able to buy it for PS4. There are going to be a physical release, but there are no date whatsoever right now. So, this spring. Oh, so it's going to be very, very soon. Sorry, I'm reading my article as I talk to you. So, let's just watch that in, see what it is. For those who don't remember, or for those who never touched it, just like me, but... Well, I didn't know what Night Trap was at the time, but I never owned a Sega CD, so which does not help, and I didn't know any friend who owned one. So, let's go! Spring 2017. Oh, you can download Night Trap song also. Physical commie, it's a limited run, so it's from limited run game. You're going to be able to get that. So limited run game. You can go check all the information. And I'm sure that's going to be something really cool to stream for PS4 owners and Xbox One owners also. Thank you, for hosting me, Kristen. I really appreciate it. And, oh yeah, Foxy Dragon Kitten also. It's really weird though, my Futaba is not reacting. I'll have to try to have to try to correct that. Anyway, so that's it. So I hope you guys will catch it once it lasts. So physical copies are really great to add to your collection, and it gives you a vintage vibe. You know, like nowadays, almost every game, like everyone, like buys like digitally. Which I'm not saying it's something bad. I'm just saying that damn, a really nice shelf with like games. That's classy. I like it. So, next news. Free PlayStation PS, free PlayStation Plus game for May 2017 has been released for PS4, PS3, and Vita. So I hope you'll be all happy with these. So let's see. So for PS4, there's Abzu. Oh yeah, I've been wanting to play that game. So Abzu, Alienation. Don't know really what it is. Laser Disco Defender. Tales from the Borderlands. Already have it. Typewriter. I'll have to try that. PS3, there's Blood Knight. Oh, interesting titles. There's going to be Port Royal 3, Pirates and Merchant. I'm not really, never really. As a big pirate fan, I was never really infatuated with like Port Royal series of game. But maybe one day I should try. I don't know. And for PS Vita, Laser Disco Defender and Typewriter. Well, okay. So, that's it. That's going to be really cool. Really, 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 really... Well, some of these games are going to be really cool. Like, for May. For April, I think we already downloaded everything. Oh, hey! Vexy Vampire. Thank you, Sui, for hosting me. I really have to check out my AI. Seriously. I'm just going to do a test. She's not starting. I'm going to have to try the stuff. Just a second, people. I'm also doing this, but what I don't understand is that she is technically in there. Okay. Now, I'm going to retry then. She's not, that's really weird. She's been doing that, like, for a bit. She's supposed to be connected and all. Well, she is there. She's there. Okay, she apparently works. Oh, no, right. I'm stupid. Okay, she works. I'm sorry, guys. Now she works. It's just whenever I'm supposed to have... She's supposed to say something whenever, like, whenever someone auto-hosts me. So, anyway, let's go. So, that were, like, the PlayStation Plus lineups for, like, May 2017. What else? Yes, this is something that really touches me as a news. The fact that Vivendi is trying, again, to take over Ubisoft. I have friends that work at Ubisoft, and... I don't want everything like to, I don't want like, things to go sour for them. I mean, they love their job. I know it. Like, I also have a friend who works at Gameloft, and, they were taken over last year by Vivendi. I don't know how much it changed everything, but, it's never really a good thing, whatever a company, and Vivendi, you know what, Vivendi, like, is a company that came out of nowhere, actually, and they just, they used to make games, I think they still do games, but we barely hear about them, and then now they just, like, doing corporate takeovers now, they've been for a few years, and now they and now they are talking about a hostile takeover, and I don't like that. I want my friends to be happy, I mean, wow. So, Vivendi is moving to the second phase. Everything will take place this year. Another source said that while Vivendi would have a limit on how much it'd be willing to spend, the logical thing would be to buy Ubisoft. So a Vivendi shareholder meeting today saw Chairman Vincent Ballour re-elected to the board despite call from some of investors supposed to move. It's still secret that Vivendi has been targeted Ubisoft for some time. It slowly acquired more and more shares of the game publisher. Since December, they have like 25% mark. A 30% French law would mandate that it pursues a controller stake in the company. Like, I mean, wow. What do you guys think about it? Will it, if Vivendi takes over like Ubisoft, well, at least has a controlling share. What do you think, guys, will happen? Comment, just tell me. Anyway, I really hope it's not going to be really bad, but I do hope Ubisoft will resist that takeover. I mean, you have to. You have to stand for your principle. You have to stand for your company. And the thing is, Ubisoft is not a company that is in the border of, like, bankruptcy or anything. I mean, this is a company that is doing pretty well with all their, like, AAA games, Assassin's Creed and everything. So good luck, Ubisoft. Good luck. And another games, I was reading, I've been following, everything's been, that's been Death Stranding since, like, the beginning it's been announced. I mean, when I saw, like, the first trailer was good, okay, cool. We have our dear Norman Reedus that is still going on with Kojima, which is a really good thing, because I think those guys could do lots of amazing projects. Everyone was shocked, everyone didn't like it when PT was cancelled. And all those people, like some of my friends, are still having PT in their console. Hold it very, very dear, because once you delete it, there's a way to get it back, but it's complicated. I've seen how to do it. It's a few steps. So I've seen actually not too long, well, a little bit after like PT was canceled, I've seen people selling their PS4 console for like a ridiculous price just because PT was still there in their account in the PS4. No one can play PT anymore unless they downloaded it before or acquired such console before, well, after like PT was discontinued. Sadly, my girlfriend got her PS4 after PT was canceled and retired from the PSN network, so we weren't able to download it, sadly. I'd like to experience it one day, you know, like some kind of like obscure collectible demo game. I mean, so anyway, about Death Stranding, apparently there's ideas from that Kojima took from Kojima and Del Toro took from working on PT, and they're assimilated it like to Death Stranding. So far we know that Mads Mikkelsen is in there to our greatest pleasure, and well, I mean this trailer. The last year's trailer, like, I think lots of people got amazed, and sometime I surprised myself and still, you know, still watching it, like, I'm still watching that trailer, like, it's been last year, but it does not show any gameplay, but just the cinematic feel to it, the music, the background, everything, Mads Mikkelsen, Del Toro, it's amazing, I really love this trailer, and I can't wait. I think the trailer is going to be with like a female support character or protagonist, or I don't know, like there's might be like a female character in the third trailer, and this trailer might probably be shown at a special event or shown E3 maybe. So hang in there, people, and it's going to be there. There's lots of speculation. I'm following Young Yeah, Amazing guy, amazing channel, everything that's news from lots of game, but I'm following more specifically his Death Stranding. His Death Stranding news. You see here, like Guillermo del Toro there. Anyway, I'm not going to say it. I'm trying to not swear that much on stream. That's follow this trending, guys. If you want lots of more information, just go to Young. Yeah, I'm gonna write it here. I've been following this guy. He's amazing. He's really cool. Go get all your news from this guy. So, let's go on with business now. Let's go a little bit in anime. Like, lots of things. Attack on Titan. I haven't watched Attack on Titan Season 2 yet. But I'm going to watch soon. It's spring. I'm getting back in my anime mood. Lots of great things. Winter was cool. Winter was cool. What was your favorite winter anime? I don't know if I don't remember if it's winter anime, but like latest big show I've watched with my girlfriend was Sangatsu no Lion, which is like March comes in like a lion. Really good show. Not a lot of action. It's just a slice of life, quiet anime with lots of emotion into it. I like it and can't wait for season two. And I think I'm going to watch like a boat live action. The first one is already out. The second one I'll have to check. Aside from that, oh wait, I'm sorry. My video feed. I'm going to restart my video feed. March comes in like a lion. There's that. There was Yojo Senki. Anyway, really good anime. I thought it was at first some kind of lolly things and all. I'm watching less and less of these anime these days, but seriously, Yojo Senki is amazing as an alternate World War One, yes. Alternate World War One universe. It's really good. It's really good. Go check this out. Aside from that, I tried to watch Gundam, Iron-Blooded Orphan. I'll have to get back into it. I really have. I haven't been into Gundam in a while. I like to keep up to date, and I like to watch old stuff. I'm going to go take a closer look to Iron-Blooded Orphan. I think I'm going to restart since the beginning. Like, I'm a huge model kit fan, and I've seen like all those people in that group that I'm following right now. All those awesome Iron-Blooded Orphan like model kits. So I'm going to go back to there. What else? So Attack on Titans 2. You know what? Speaking of medieval like stuff, remembers Spice and Wolf? That's something I love. I love Spice and Wolf, and now I can watch it whenever I want. Since my girlfriend a couple of years ago bought me season 1 and 2 on Blu-ray DVD box set. Have to revisit that thing. Anyway, I'd like a third season. It did not end it like as well as I wanted to. I should probably do like a anime discussion podcast. There's that. Aside from that, what else do we have? Mobile Suit Gundam 0083 Stardust Memory People, my personal favorite Gundam anime. I know it's just a bunch of OVAs, but man, that was so good. The mech design, the story, the characters are unforgettable. Okay, yeah, Ko is the least interesting of the bunch, I have to admit. But even so, I loved it. I loved it. Like, you get like a huge 80s vibe there. It's really good. The Zaku, the Physalis. Physalis is really, 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 really good mecha design. Lieutenant Burning is just an amazing pilot. He dies a cheap, cheesy death. Well, not cheesy, but a cheap death. Seriously, a cheap death. Annabelle Gatto is probably, next to Char Aznable, probably like the best protagonist in the Gundam universe. Aside from that, what I like is that, it happens before Z Gundam, but I would have loved if we would have some insight about what happened to Ko in Z Gundam after Stardust Memory. The animation is really, really, really good for its era, and you know what? Cell animation is just amazing. I can't get my eyes out of that. Like, nowadays, yeah, they're doing about, like, everything by computer. But it's good. Computer animation these days is really good. But seriously, for me, it will never beat Cell animation. I love Cell animation. I forgot the name. I forgot, like, my favorite character of that. Well, I'm, just a second. Where is she? I don't remember her name. It's really, really sad. Just a second. Yeah, the last fleet. Just a second there. It's a great coming of age story. Too literary and South Burning. Kelly Leisner. Stoic former Zeon pilot. Kelly Leisner. Kelly was really cool. Feline gal. Mecha design while the Gundam. Series is home to some unique and beautiful Zeon suit. Yes, yes. Most mostly associated with this. Yeah, Kermit and background light benefits from his crisp blue transfer. I have to buy this thing. It. I don't remember her name. Just a second there. Sorry guys. Sima, yeah, Sima Garahau. Yes, she is my favorite Gundam badass ever. She's amazing. So you guys, you need to go check that. I think it's for me, it's the best Gundam story. Like, it's my top number one. This is my opinion. It's my top number one. But if you don't know about it, just go see it. Just go see it. Okay. Yeah. Hiroki Yasumoto, voice actor from Yastora, Chado, Sado, and Bleach. Andrew Gilbert in Sword Art Online. Yeah, he's on the hiatus because he's been diagnosed with, wait just a second, that just came in, Attack on Titan Season 2, Girl Beats Boy, Digimon Adventure Try Yamato, Strike the Blood, okay, yeah, before the end of the year he's gonna come back. Fellow actors, just gonna to treat his throat after Doctor. So yeah, so he's not going to be replaced for his in his show, but he's going to come back by the end of the year. So if people like Yoshimasa Osoya, for those like me who are purists and watch most of their anime like in the original language, that's it. I don't have much to say about that. Here, Yoshiyuki Tomino discussed new G Reconquista movie. So Reconquista has not ended. You know what? Who just like me thinks that whenever Tomino puts his hand into an anime, into Gundam, Gundam season, it's like, whoa, it's like, whoa, it's really, it's something really unique. Not everyone appreciate, but it's really unique. Like, I was not big, I'm not a big fan of, Turn A Gundam. I mean, I've watched Turn A Gundam, but I'm not a big fan of it. What else? Victory Gundam. Yeah, Victory Gundam, like, really infamous to have the single highest death count in all the Gundam universe, all the Gundam season. I did not count them, but everyone's... but it's been recognized for that, because, you see, like, as I read... Tomino, when he did write V Gundam, he was under severe depression, so he killed a lot of characters. And it's really funny because there's actually a scene in there when he when like those enemy girls that like are trying to trap Uso Iwin, he's the protagonist pilots of Victory Gundam, in a space, a space station or a colony or something, anyway, and they get out of their Gundam in bikinis wearing, and sporting bazookas, and they're trying to kill him. And, yeah, well, not surprisingly, they're almost all die in explosion. Yeah, Uso sliced these girls with his beam saber. You should see that scene. So, you know what? Victory Gundam is a must watch. It's long from time to time, but it's a nice watch. You have to at least watch it once. So, I mean, wow, like, yeah, so Tomino will do a movie for, is talking about, for, Reconquista and Gisa. For everyone who loved it, that's great. I have to finish it. I like the suit design. I like the pilots are cool. Everything's cool. It's just that it did not catch my attention at first. But I'm going to go back into it. I mean, I'm a big Gundam fan. I've been trying to watch everything Gundam I can put my hands on, my eyes on. So watch out for Tomino, guys. It also reminds me that I actually did an oral presentation about this guy and model and the invention of model kits, Gunpla, back in the 80s for my Japanese class. I still have that oral presentation. It was called Kusai, like an odor of model kit. Kusai means it stinks in Japanese. So watch out for Tomino, guys. Another Reconquista in G, well, not another movie, but a new movie is coming. What else? Yeah, Star Wars manga return with Lost Star adaptation, and Line App also all hold a competition to draw Heir to the Jedi Lord of the Sith manga. So new Star Wars manga is always welcome, as it's like so entertaining. I've read a couple of them, and it's actually fun. You should try that. So the series will debut for free in the apps on May 4th. So you have to get the Line app, which I have. I haven't read really much from there, though. But I should try. I mean, I love Star Wars manga. It's a fresh take. Awesome drawings. as you can see there, like, not necessarily the emperor, but Darth Vader looks really, really, really badass. Have you seen his commercial? Just a second, I'm going to show you that. It's really, really, really old. No, I don't want to go to YouTube. I want to go to YouTube. Yes, I want to quit this thing. Okay, YouTube. I'm so bad with the keyboard sometimes. So, YouTube. Okay, so. Star Wars tuna commercial. Yeah, it was for tuna. So, Star Wars Japanese fish tuna commercial. So, watch that. Oh, just a second, guys. Just a second. Where's the didn't work. Well, sorry about that. Where when we start that? So, hey, Vexy, how you doing? I was just about to show like a really crazy Japanese commercial. So, I hope you like. So, here it is. I was talking about like a Star Wars manga adaptation. There's some new ones that are coming. And I just wanted to show that because Japan knows what to do with Darth Vader and the whole Star Wars cast. It's so cool. So, enjoy this oldies. So that's about it. I love that commercial. I don't know why. I don't even know what they're saying. Probably like, oh, this is delicious space tuna or something like that. They seem to be really, really having a big, big fun with that. So that's it. So the app will accept. Okay, so there's also a campaign for you guys out there. So for you guys out there who really likes, who likes to draw and think have a chance, you can always like try to draw your own Star Wars manga. It has to be a submission of at least 12 pages, and they're accepting candidate from May 4th to August 31st. So get your pencil on and draw Star Wars stuff. Next thing, here you go. Yeah, for those who have been following and playing Super Robot War, even we like barely had like any of these games around here in North America, I think two or three. Well, for those who are good enough for reading Japanese and have been playing Super Robot War for a while, now you can get the original Megazord as a limited time event. Like, if you see him, like, is that like apps or something? But anyway, so you can get the guy, lots of robots, the Zords, awesome. Anyone pop by besides me? No, you're the only one. You're the only one. There's just Futaba with me like always. Idol Master Kotori is getting her own spin-off manga. I can't wait for this because Kotori is one of my favorite characters. You don't see her very often in the anime, but yeah, she's my favorite. She's one of my favorites from Idol Master. It's going to be written by the Edo manga sensei writer and Idol Master Cinderella Girl. I mean, I really like Edo manga sensei, so this should be entertaining. It's going to be really, really cool. So it's going to be in Morning, it's called Morning Glow is Golden, the Idol Master. It's going to be in the next monthly Comic Rex magazine on May 27th. So it's coming And oh yeah, I do like the twins. Don't worry about that. But she is also, I mean, you can have more than one favorite character in a series. But yeah, so Kotori is one of my waifu. So for all those Kotori fans, please watch for that manga. For those who loves, oh wait, oh yeah, 21st Detective Conan movies. I'll have to watch it. You know what? I have a lot to do in term of Meitante Conan. Meitante Conan, Karakurenai no Ravureta. Detective Conan, Crimson Love Letter, or Case Closed, for those who watch the American series. Anyway, that's cool, but I was actually checking, like, for a second live-action film on Sangatsu no Rayon. March comes in like a lion. So, Chris, we'll have to watch the first movie, and then the second movie is coming. So that's going to be awesome! Watch for it! I love that anime. Bing. Now, for those who think can draw well and live in Japan or will live in Japan or something, Kodansha is recruiting staff to create the largest scale manga application in history. Oh, manga application. Wait, just a second. Oh, it's not people to draw, it's people to program and apps. Well, that's going to be really interesting. The slogan has already been decided. Let's read manga every day. We are now moving forward under that slogan on the overwhelming largest scale manga application in history, plus a devilishly appealing website. Together with us, usher in a new phase in the world of manga. We are overwhelming recruiting for our team of energetic people full of dream and anguish. Well, that's going to be cool, but it's probably just going to be like a probably going to be only in Japanese and with no possible English release. So if you're better than me in Japanese, which is not very hard, you can always wait and get that apps whenever it's out. There's really going to be more announcements soon. Bing. So, something I've been seeing like for a couple of weeks now, it's Atom the Beginning, which interests me. It has a pretty decent the second episode has a pretty decent score. Anyone who decides to attack a kid in a school uniform who looks younger than her teenage has to be a villain in my book. I'll have to look at that. Something that's going to be so Atom the Beginning is currently streaming on Amazon's Anime Strike. I'll have to check that. Probably a paying service, which sadly I don't have. I can't subscribe yet to those things. But anyway, I'm going to try to find a way to watch that. Looks interesting. Throw me back to when I was a teenager and I would go to school and watch anime. Ero manga sensei novels have 1 million copies in print. The novel. I've been reading the novel, translation of the novel, because there's no physical English novel yet, I think. And it's from Dangeki Bunko. So I hope if ever they get like a second Dangeki Bunko fighting climax game, out there, maybe for PS4 this time. I want her to be a character. I want her to be there. Ero Manga Sensei, I've watched the first episode, I've read the first few chapters, and so far it's really good. I can't wait to check the rest. The live-action Ghost in the Shell film earns US $900,000 in fourth weekend. In Japan, I think. Wait. Whoa. No, wait. The film has an estimated total gross of US 39,131,504 dollars in the US, ranked 19th for the weekend. Wow, for something that people were complaining about, oh damn, it's whitewashing, oh damn, it does not follow the original story and everything, blah blah blah. Well, people still managed to go a lot there. Yeah. Sadly, I can't go to theater these days, but I'm going to wait probably when it's going to be, like, physically available. I'm a big fan of Ghost in the Shell, and I'm actually running a Ghost in the Shell role-playing game session every 2 weeks with my role-playing friends. Madoka Magica character transformed into flower fairies in Lawson collaboration. So who are you people who goes to Lawson every day, every 2 days, whatever. Here you go. You have these awesome things that, sadly, me and my girlfriend cannot have access to. So count yourself lucky if you are in Japan right now, or if you plan to go in Japan. These are must collector. You see, they sell long de chat, which is kind of like a French French-made cookies with light cookies, like with chocolate inside. And you can get all those awesome collector cards, product, keychain, and it's a tie-up event for the third Madoka Magica film thriller. The Rebellion, movies has been out, I think. I've watched it. It's really good, but it cannot be over after the third movie. Not with everything that's been happening. So stay put, guys. This is really cool, awesome material. I love those dress. I'd like to see cosplay. And you know what? I think my favorite dress is this one, the red one. It's a really, really cool dress. So that's about it for everything that's been news, with spilling a lot of beans and all. Wow, Call of Duty World War II. They're coming back to their former glory. Which is good. I mean, I'll never quit on World War II games. It's like so cool. You can do so much with that. Even like so many years later, like everything that's been like modern era Call of Duty and all, like it's not so well. Didn't get like. The best response compared to everything that was like World War II in the past. World War II is probably like everyone's favorite era of war. Lots of action, the weapons, everything was like interesting on a technical point of view. I know like it's not the happiest time in history also, but it's still, you know, like remembered by, I think when you think like, name me like, a war that's been happening in the past, everyone's like, World War II, World War II, you know, like, so, I guess, Capcom say Resident Evil 7, not a hero DLC, is not yet good enough to be released, so, there's the lost tape, and there's that. So, anything else you guys would like to discuss? Because I think that's it for my news. I'll be posting that probably on YouTube for people to enjoy for posterity. So what would be the video of the day? Let's see. Let's see Japanese Star Wars a little bit here. Well, what's that? Let's go on that.
めてわしの計画通り。
話しなさい、話しなさい。
全然覚えてない。
やはりあなたの仕業でしたか。私をオーレラン、オーデランシッシン、オーデランシッシンのプリンセスレイラ・オーガナとしてのブレカ。これは戦争です。宇宙戦争です。つまりスターウォーズです。ルーク・スカイウォーカー、 C-3PO、 R2-D2 の3人がきっと私を助けに来ます。そうして私はルーク・スカイウォーカー、 C-3PO、 R2-D2 の救出されるでしょう。なぜならルーク・スカイウォーカー、 C-3PO、 R2-D2 は私のベストパートナーだからです。
いや、それで終わるですか？
Sorry。What is that? Where is he?This Luke Skywalker looks weird. Anyway. But you guys, have you seen like news about like Battlefront 2? It's going to be amazing. You know, like that's what we're waiting for, like when they release when Battlefront 3. Battlefront 3. I still consider it that, and Battlefront 2 is Battlefront 4. So, yeah. This is what we've been waiting for, me and to my friend, because the first one was a disappointment for a lot of people there. Oops. Sorry, I'm just going to be doing this, and I'm going to be bing. So yeah, it was a disappointment for a lot of people, but the new one looks pretty, really, really promising. So, you know what? I'm going to be playing a little bit of game, and then I'm going to do other things. So thank you very much for you guys to have like watched my my first podcast. I'm going to prepare for my game. So just sit tight, and I'm going to start something. Or you know what? What time is it? Sorry, 1:44. Yeah. Well. Let me think about it. Yeah. You know what? Yeah. I'm going to start walking the 400 days. So sit tight. I'll be back.